is good, everybody? Welcome back to another My Damn Toys video. This shit is not for kids. Getting into an epic video today. We have plenty of stuff to show you guys, and I haven't even gotten to the best part that is in this video, guys. I have a huge shout out to give. I mean, we got some epic things going on in this video that I have to show you. I have an epic custom to show you guys, but I do want to start off with the big thing that happened on WWE television, guys. If you missed Friday Night SmackDown, you guys know that the Universal Championship, right? The Universal Championship is no longer on Monday Night Raw, so they have changed the color of the championship belt to blue. So we have a custom Universal Championship in Friday Night SmackDown blue going on right here. We have the Bray Wyatt Fiend in the middle. It's the Fiend Bray Wyatt, you stupid jackass. Not the Bray Wyatt Fiend. It's the Fiend. So getting it right here, guys, what we did basically, I mean, it's very simple, very easy thing to do. I may do a, you know, a how-to video on it. It's not the hardest thing to do in the world, but let's go ahead and get it right here off of Bray Wyatt. Got the Universal Championship as well. And basically, it's basically just a regular championship, just painted, except you can't avoid some paint, and we'll get into that. But basically what we've done, ladies and gentlemen, is we took a WWE championship and we took the SmackDown Live Women's Championship and we took off the middle plate, you guys know. So this stuff right here is not painted. This is the regular championship. And we took the WWE championship from Mattel. You know, they give it to us with what, every single figure nowadays. So we took the WWE title, removed all the plates, you know, so you don't get any paint or anything on there. Makes it very easy to paint. You want to take those plates off, and then you're going to take your I wanted to use a WWE championship. That way I added a base coat of white over the black strap, and then I came back with a ceram coat royal blue color. I think it's called True Blue or something. I'll have to, you know, double check that. If we do the how-to video, I will definitely show you guys the exact color that I used and where to get that paint and everything. Hit me in the comment section below if you want to see a how-to video on how to make the new Universal Championship. But again, taking that WWE title, base coating it in white, and then coming back with that blue color. I mean, I think it's a pretty, like, perfect color, if you guys can tell. Like, it looks like this is the exact same color as far as the plate is concerned compared to the strap, and it came on there pretty cleanly. We did seal it up with matte Mod Podge, and it looks pretty solid, you know, nothing too crazy. You know, it doesn't chip. The buttons right here I didn't want to do just because, you know, it gets messy and stuff like that, and it'll be too thick to go through the holes.
Giggity giggity.
And I didn't want to make that the case. So this is the new Universal Championship. I did not paint the back because that, again, would have been really messy. No point in painting the back, and you really won't see the back anyway. So that is it, man. The blue Universal Championship. I also did paint the side plates right here in the cracks. You do have the blue right there. But again, use the SmackDown Live Women's Championship middle plate so you don't have to paint that. It's just the best thing to do. I had like two or three of them, so I just took that middle plate, switched it over to the WWE Championship, and called it a day. But there is the new Universal Championship in blue, but this is just one of the things I have to show you guys in this video because there's so much epicness going on. I guess I can get into the custom now. I did want to show off the new Universal title. I think it looks pretty good. I mean, compared to the red one, I think the red one, you know, we've had this since 2016. You know, it's ran its course. I would have preferred them bring back the World Heavyweight Championship or the big gold or something, you know, just to give us some nostalgia, give us something new, or give us a brand new looking championship. Instead, they just do the cookie cutter bull crap or the cookie cutter bullshit, and we end up with the same exact championship. How many championships do we have now that look like this? Same amount of championships that look like this as before. Same exact number. But there is our two championships. So there is that. There is the Bray Wyatt Fiend. Saying that again like a jackass. But anyways, guys, I have a beautiful custom that I have to show you guys, and I'm gonna do that right now. So coming into the screen, guys, is this custom pink and white Ricochet football figure. Look at how gorgeous this is. Holy Christ on a bicycle. I love this. I think this is absolutely fantastic. Oh my God. God, just look at it. Would you just look at it? Bask in its glory, ladies and gentlemen. Look at the pink tights with the white and everything. I love this. I'm a big fan of Ricochet. I think he's absolutely fantastic. He's definitely kind of stale on the microphone. You know, he's not the best on the microphone, but his in-ring work is just, you know, he's just over the top. It's kind of a pun because, you know, he goes over the top rope. He flies around the ring. But right here, guys, this custom actually comes to us from my boy, Mac, and it is Mac Decals. I want to show off his stuff here because he is the best, guys. He's one of the most underrated in the world. And I'll tell you this right now. You can see right there, at @Mac_decals. You guys know that I do Dammy Awards every single year. Well, last year, the 2019 Lookout Award, Mac Decals won that thing. And I think it's for good reason. I mean, look at this. Look at this. And this is just a fraction of the work that the man can do. The dude is an absolute baller. Dude is posting epic customs every week, it seems. And he can do all kinds of stuff that you'll see in this video. But right there, you see Mac Decals. Thank you for your order. You got, there's just an example of his work right there, including this beautiful Ricochet. And we're going to get into this right now because I'm, my God in heaven. Of course, you have your Elite 69 head sculpt. You have your Elite 69 torso. I think he did spray this Ricochet arm, so he does have like the white sleeve look. I think that is absolutely fantastic. And it has not paint chipped. I've bent this arm a few times now, and it definitely has not paint chipped. I'm not sure how well it would do under pick fed circumstances, but I'm sure I could pick fed with it. And if the arm chipped, I could always replace it with a regular Ricochet arm with no problems. Over here, guys, this is something he always does, and I got this on my other custom from him, is that his the wrist tape is like, it's like he has elastic or rubber, and he puts it over the wrist tape, so it's not painted on there. It's like legitimate wrist tape, which is something I don't think I've ever seen besides Nick's Custom Toys on Instagram. It is not, you know, it's not painted on, it's not sculpted on, but it is actually like a removable wristband that is like, I don't really know how to describe it, but it's fantastic. But the pink color is really nice. You guys know, he posted this up on Instagram, and I had to have it because you guys know it's one of my favorite colors. It fits the channel. You have the white tied in with the belt and the Ricochet logos, established 1988. You got the one and only knee pad, white knee pads and white lower legs give it that, you know, full white look on the bottom. And this is just gorgeous, man. I'm so freaking happy, dude. Mac, you absolutely killed it, man. And I'm sure this is not even close to the last order that I will make for you. He used the perfect formula too, guys. He got rid of those long ass legs. He gave us the Sin Cara legs, I do believe, and it's just beautiful, man. He nailed it, and I'm so happy. This is beautiful. He actually added the black outsoles as well, so huge shout out to Mac Decals, guys. Definitely go give him a follow, and let me know down in the comment section below what you think of the pink Ricochet. This is gorgeous, man. He freaking destroyed it, but that's not all he sent us, guys. He actually sent us a lot more, and we're gonna get into that right now. First of all, he sent us this other championship title, and you're probably like, oh, Brad, that's just a regular WWE championship. Correction, Brad. That is actually a WWF championship. You can see there, ladies and gentlemen, he has replaced the WWE scratch logo with the WWF scratch logo. And this is actually accurate because Mattel cannot put WWF on there, obviously, from the lawsuit from the World Wildlife Foundation, I think it is. It's the WWF. They actually, you know, sued the WWE or told the WWE, you know, you got to get rid of the F or we're going to sue the shit out of you. And so they got rid of the F and, you know, they switched to WWE. And so now it's up to customizers like Mac to give us accurate title belts. And this is gorgeous, man. That scratch logo right there is just nostalgic for me. This is when I started watching wrestling, and this is going to look epic on The Rock, Triple H, Stone Cold Steve Austin's probably who I'm going to put it on. And I definitely am going to have to get more of these for the shelf, for the display shelf. This looks so nice, dude. It looks freaking badassery. I love this. And we're definitely going to be using this on display. What a freaking beast. And he did throw this in for free. I did not pay for this. He actually hooked me up with this, and you are a baller, Mac. So Mac hooked us up with this. And that's not all, ladies and gentlemen. He actually hooked us up with a few more things, which is just totally unnecessary, but we love it. As I said, he makes the, you know, the wristbands. Well, he hooked us up with 4 Undisputed Era armbands. And so, like I said, guys, the wrist tape deal, he does the same thing for the upper arm. It's the same material. He's got the logo printed on there. I don't know how he prints the logo on there. I don't know if this is Decals. I'm sure it is Decals. I mean, Decals is in his name, for Christ's sake. So he gave us 4 of these, and I guess I'm going to put them on my Undisputed Era, man. It's going to look epic. You guys can see in the background, we do have our Undisputed Era. So we are going to add that up there. And again, dude, I don't know how the hell he makes this, like, wrist tape or, like, rubber. I don't know how the hell it works. But let's go ahead and just, let's just take Bobby Fish here. I do have, you know, this, like, painted on. But I did want to stick this on there and see what it looks like, see how well it fits and stuff. And it does seem like it fits pretty John Brown well. You guys know that all of mine have the painted on armband, so I'll probably have to replace that. But they look great, man. They look terrific. You guys can see there, just look how more official that looks. They're looking like John Cena over here with their bicep bands. That is clean as shit, dude. Thank you so very much. Now all my Undisputed Era are going to look even more undisputed. Freaking ridiculous. Thank you so much, brother. That is freaking fantastic, guys. So definitely go check out Mac. I cannot wait to get some use out of this Ricochet and all these Undisputed Era armbands and stuff. And I do have one more thing to show you guys before we get out of here today. But we do have the Undisputed Era armbands. We have the WWF Championship, which looks so good. I mean, the freaking we got the blue Universal Championship. I mean, I'm bringing the heat today, ladies and gentlemen, mostly because of Mac. Beautiful looking Ricochet, but we have one more thing to show you guys. You guys know the Elite Champion Kenny Omega, right? I posted a new teaser for what he will be wearing at Hell's Gate. Well, I went to eBay, Brad, and I tried to find like a gun for him to use for his entrance, and I found this AK-47 made out of diecast metal, and I thought, you know, it said 1/12 scale. Does this look 1/12 scale to you? I feel like it's way too big. I'm not an expert in guns or anything, but I feel like this is a little bit too big. It just looks a little too big to me. I think it needs to be shrunk by like 25%, and then it would probably be, but it's still, I mean, it's decent, but when you put it in his hand, guys, it's just, it looks too big, and plus it's so heavy that it'll probably like fall over and stuff. Let me fix his hand. So there you go. You got Kenny Omega holding the AK. See, like when he's holding it, guys, you can just see how massive it is. It's kind of ridiculous. So you put it like that, and he's holding it, and it's just a massive AK-47. Like, look how big that AK-47 is. And I just don't think he can hold it properly. It just looks weird and dumb to me. You guys can see right there. So AK-47 for Kenny Omega, and it's just too big. So it's not going to work for now. So there's your little teaser for, you know, just what I'm going to be doing for Hell's Gate for Kenny Omega. I'm going to try my best to get him a gun in scale, and he's going to come out with that, I guess. But the AK is too big, but I did want to include it. They also threw in this like AR-15 with the big old scope on it, but again, way too big. Still made of diecast metal. But let me know what you think of the AK, guys. Too big in my opinion, but I did want to show it off in the video just to get your guys' ideas on it. But I think that is going to do it for today's video, guys. Again, a huge shout out to Mac for making this video possible, man. And let me know down in the comment section below if you want me to make a tutorial on how to make the new Universal Championship. But that is going to do it for today's video, guys. Thank you so very much for watching. I hope you guys did enjoy. Go give Mac a follow. Let me know down in the comment section below what you think of the Ricochet, the new Universal Championship, the Undisputed Era armbands, the new WWF Championship, the Kenny Omega AK-47. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at MyDamnToys. Subscribe to the channel for more epic WWE action figure videos, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you so much, Mac. Thank you.